بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. اللهم انفعنا بما علمتنا وعلمنا ما ينفعنا وزدنا علما. اللهم وفقنا لما تحب وترضى وجنبنا الفواحش ما ظهر منها وما بطن. اللهم صل وسلم نبي الهدى قادر التقوى صلى الله عليه وسلم صلى الله عليه وسلم صلى الله عليه وسلم. أحمدك حمد الحامدين وأشكرك شكر الشاكرين. So we were going through the chapter from the book of Dua, Da'awat, the book of prayers from the Sahih of Imam Bukhari rahimahullah. And we were in the chapter of Bab al-Dua fi al-Salah, Dua in Salah. So last week we went through some of the narrations. Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu asking the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, O Prophet of Allah, give me a dua which I can make in my salah. So the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam told him to read, Allahumma inni zalamtu nafsi zulman kathira wa la yaghfiru adh-dhunuba illa anta faghfir li maghfiratan min 'indika warhamni innaka antal ghafurur rahim, which we all read at the end of our salah. Moving on with the narration. حدثنا عثمان بن أبي شيبة حدثنا جرير عن منصور عن أبي وائل عن عبد الله رضي الله عنه قال كنا نقول في الصلاة. عبد الله بن مسعود رضي الله عنه says that we used to say in our salah, السلام على الله, peace be upon Allah, salutations upon Allah, والسلام على فلان, salutations upon فلان, so and so. Meaning, we should actually start listing the names. Peace be upon, salutations upon so and so, so and so, so and so. فَقَالَ لَنَا النَّبِيُّ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ ذَاتَ يَوْمٍ. So the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said to us one day, إِنَّ اللَّهَ هُوَ السَّلَامُ. Indeed, Allah is salam. One of the names of Allah is salam. Allah is filled with salutations. Allah is the one who gives peace, tranquility, etc. So you don't need to send salutations on him. He's the one who bestows it on others. Okay? فَإِذَا قَعَدَ أَحَدُكُمْ. When one of you sit في الصلاة, in your salah, when one of you sits in salah, فَلْيَقُلْ. He should say, التَّحِيَّاتُ لِلَّهِ. All my worship is for Allah. التحيات. All my worship is for Allah. إِلَى قَوْلِهِ تِلْ الصَّالِحِينَ. Meaning, As-salamu alayna wa ala ibadillahi salihin. Salutations upon us and upon all the pious slaves. Upon ibadillah, on the slaves of Allah, which are salih, salihin, pious slaves. Fa'idha qalaha, when he said that, meaning when he said that, that salam be upon us and upon the slaves of Allah who are pious. أصاب كل عبد لله في السماء والأرض صالح. It will bestow, it will go gain, it will be achieved by every slave of Allah in the heavens or the earth who is pious. Any pious person out there who has some piety in his life, who does pious deeds, imagine. Piety, doing good deeds is so sacred, so virtuous, that in every salah, every person is sending salutations upon you. How many people must have been performing salah? Just for example, Jummah today. How many people must have performed Jummah today? And then all the masajid all over the world. Imagine. And everybody who performs salah, what do they say? As-salamu alayna wa ala ibadillahi salihin. So all the people, all the millions and millions of people, billions of people, their salutations, the blessings are coming down on the person who is pious. Pious person, everything is making dua for him. Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah. I testify, I bear witness that there is no God but Allah. Ashhadu anna Muhammadan abduhu wa rasuluhu. And I bear witness that Muhammad is his slave and his prophet. ثم تخير من الثناء ما شاء. Then he has a choice from the glory of Allah, whatever he wishes. Then he can mention, read any other dua He can read Allahumma inni zalamtu nafsi zulman kathira, or he can read Rabbana atina fid dunya hasana wa fil akhirati hasana wa qina adhaban nar. Just the other day I came across something really amazing. A person should try his best to do as many pious deeds as he can. He shouldn't just waste his time. He should try to read as much dhikr as possible, as much durood sharif as possible. So he's not wasting his time. He's not. And many people say, if I am reading too much, then people will look at me as some really pious person. Is there something wrong? Do you want people to look at you as shaitan? Do you want people to look at you as Firaun? It's good that people look at you and people regard you as good, pious people. It's good. As long as you yourself don't regard yourself as pious. You shouldn't. The minute you think I am something, I am pious, your piety is gone out of the window. You need to endeavor, try your best to become as pious as possible. Others can regard you as pious, but you should never regard yourself as pious. That's a very fine line. Very fine line. Today we regard ourselves as pious. Nobody else regards us as pious. No. And if we become pious in the true sense, if we become pious in the true sense, then we will get the dua of every person, every who's performing salah all over the world, because we will come into the category of salih. Salihin. We'll come into the category of salihin. We will get all the du'as. Imagine how beautiful piety is. How beautiful doing a good deed is. It is mentioned in some narrations, the Tabi'een used to say that إِنَّ اللَّهَ لَا يَحْفَظُ بِالرَّجُلِ الصَّالِحِ. Allah will protect, safeguard due to the piety of a person, the pious, due to one pious person, his children, his grandchildren, and all the homes around the area. So one person is staying away from the disobedience of Allah, one person is staying his life as much as possible, fulfilling the commands of Allah, trying his best to do as you know his life according to piety. Not only is he benefiting himself, but he's benefiting his progeny and he's benefiting all the area around him. Everything around him has an effect. Just like one person's crime has an effect in the whole area. This area is full of crimes. People say this area is full of robbery. That doesn't mean every single person in that area is committing crime. Not even half may be committing the crime. But there's a good percentage that are doing it. In the same way, if crime can have such effect on the whole area that the whole area can become, you know, known as a hub of criminals and a hub of crime, why cannot, you know, piety and pious people in an area who are working towards becoming pious become, you know, such salihin and protect the people of that area? So we should aim for this, inshallah. That should be our aim. Oh Allah, make me pious. Oh Allah, grant me piety. Oh Allah, fill my life up with pious deeds. Take away all the evil deeds from me. So that is what we should do in salah. At-tahiyyatu lillah. Bab al-du'a ba'da salah. What du'a should you make after salah? So after you finish your salah, what should you say? Do you just rush out of the masjid? Is that what you do? As soon as the second salam does not even finish and already out of the masjid. Jum'ah, before the imam gets up, three quarters of the masjid already empty. The imam thinking, was I performing salah here alone or something? Happens. And what is our attitude? We go to the masjid saying that, let me go and finish the salah off, I have more important things to do. So meaning, performing salah is nothing important, it's just something which I need to do. I have very important meeting I have left. I have very important work I need to go back to. So don't waste my time. Don't go a minute here and there. I've got much more important things to do. Meaning whatever I am doing in front of Allah in masjid is not important at all to me. That is our attitude to our salah. And then we want the world to change. When we are not ready to change our attitude to the commands of Allah, we are coming to the masjid thinking as if I am doing some type of favor to Allah. And as soon as salah is finished, immediately walk out. The box has been ticked. Why do I need to? I don't know. I've got so many things to do. Allah protect. The moments after salah is so valuable, so precious. In some books I have read them as the golden moments. You have just bowed down in front of Allah. You have just performed your salah. You have just gone as close as possible a person can ever get to Allah in sajda. Now, whatever zikr you will do, whatever dua you will make, whatever supplication you will do, do you think Allah will not be accepting that? You know, value those moments. Sit in the masjid for another half a minute after salah. Just half a minute or 1 minute. With the intention that me sitting in the masjid is also rewarding. It's an act of reward. I'm getting extra reward on this. It's not that namaz is over, I'm not going to get anything more now. The Prophet of Allah says, وَالْجُلُوثُ فِي الْمَسَاجِدِ Sitting in the masjid is also an act of reward. So sit in the masjid for that one extra minute, that half a minute, 20 seconds, 30, 40 seconds. And just me sitting, let me get that extra income. People nowadays, they get really happy. It's like a side income. The extra money on the side. Weekend job. Evening jobs. They love all these kinds of things. You know, extra here, a little bit of money here. And there. When it comes to Akhirah, now I've done my salah. Let us make that extra bit. Stay in the masjid. Get into the habit of coming to the masjid early. Get into the habit of staying in the masjid after salah. Why do we have certain sunnah of salah which are before salah, before the faraz, certain sunnah after faraz, certain sunnah before and after? Yeah. In every salah, nearly every salah, we have something before and after, or before or after. Yeah. To mentally prepare us that when you go to the masjid, go a bit early, read that 4 rakat, read that 2 rakat, clear your mind from everything that is outside. So when you're ready for that further salah, your mind is empty already and only you are thinking about Allah and nothing else in your salah. Otherwise you're running in directly when the fadr is about to finish. Then your mind is all over the place, your mind is out there, and in salah you're not thinking about Allah at all. Everything else is in your mind except for Allah. When a person is standing in front of Allah and he's thinking of other things besides Allah, then Allah says, O my slave, Yabna Adam, what the son of Adam, Ila man taltafit, where are you going to? You are standing in front of me, what are you thinking? Where is your mind going? Where is your mind off to? Ila man huwa khayrun minni, have you found somebody better than me? You found somebody better than me, you are standing in front of me, you are thinking about other things. That's why we should try our best to stay focused. Allah, Allah, Allah. And the best way the ulama derive to stay focused in our salah is to concentrate on what we are reading in the salah. Subhana rabbiyal azim, subhana rabbiyal azim, subhana. Concentrate. Understand the meanings of it. What I am saying in my rukut to Allah, what I am saying in my sajda to Allah, what the imam is reading in salah, what I am reading in my own salah, what tilaw I am doing. Not just inna atina qul huwallah. The shortest surah we know, Inna atina qul huwallah. 2 minutes, 2 rakat. Nothing more than that. Allah give us the ability. So after salah, the dua to make after salah, Allah make us greedy for the akhirah. Allah make us greedy for Jannah. That is how the sahaba were. Today we are very, very greedy for that extra bit of income, for that extra money. If only we had that same passion, that same greed for Jannah, for Akhirah. to get that extra reward. حدثني إسحاق أخبرنا يزيد أخبرنا ورقاء عن سمي عن أبي صالح عن أبي هريرة رضي الله عنه قالوا يا رسول الله they said, O Prophet of Allah. So Abu Hurairah رضي الله عنه says, the companions they came to the Prophet of Allah, he said, O Prophet of Allah, ذهب أهل الدثور بالدرجات والنعيم. The wealthy people, the rich people, they have gone with high ranks, درجات, high ranks, they have taken it, والنعيم and the blessings. They have taken all the eternal muqim, all the eternal blessings, they've taken it away. How did they take it away? قال, the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said, كيف ذاك? How is that? What do you mean? قال, صلوا كما صلينا, they perform salah, how we perform salah, so in that we are the same. وجاهدوا كما جاهدنا, they strive, how we strive in the path of Allah, so we are the same. But the advantage they have is وأنفقوا من فضول أموالهم, they spend from the extra of the wealth. We don't have that much. We don't have wealth. They've got the wealth, so they spend from that. We can't do it. وليست لنا أموال, we don't have money. قال, so the Prophet, imagine the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said, أفلا أخبركم, shall I not inform you بأمر of something تدركون من كان قبلكم, you will be able to catch up with those that have gone before you, you will be able to catch all that you would have. وَتَسْبِقُونَ مَنْ جَاءَ بَعْدَكُمْ, and you will, you know, be ahead of those who come behind you. You will be in front of other people. وَلَا يَأْتِي أَحَدٌ بِمِثْلِ مَا جِئْتُمْ, and nobody will come with that which you have bought, إِلَّا مَنْ جَاءَ بِمِثْلِهِ, except they have done exactly what you have done. Meaning, you will be on such a rank, such a position, nobody will be able to get that rank unless they've done that same thing. Unless... تسبحون في دبر كل صلاة عشرة. Say Subhanallah after every salah 10 times. Now many people say 33 times, that's too much. But we can say 10 times. 10 times is no big deal. So at least one third, less than one third of it, 10 times. Subhanallah, Subhanallah, Subhanallah. 10 seconds. 10? 10 seconds. Subhanallah 10 times. وتحمدون عشرا. Say Alhamdulillah 10 times. وتكبرون أشرا and say الله أكبر 10 times. 30, half a minute. After salah, just sit there in half a minute, 10, 10, 10. Then you will be ahead of everyone in terms of your rank, in terms of your deeds. Nobody will be able to beat you until they also doing the same thing. تابعه عبيد الله بن عمر عن سمي ورواه ابن عجان عن سمي ورجاء ابن حيوة ورواه جرير عن عبد العزيز بن غفي عن ابي صالح عن ابي الدرداء ورواه سهيل عن ابيه عن ابي هريره رضي الله عنه عن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم. So this is very very easy. After every salah, if we are unable to do 33 times, at least we can do 10 times. Such great reward for such small deeds, something which we can do in half a minute, and such high ranks Allah is ready to give us. Such, so much reward Allah is ready to give. حدثنا قتيبة بن سعيد قال حدثنا جرير المنصور عن المسيب ابن غافي عن الوراد مولى المغيرة ابن شعبة قال كتب المغيرة إلى معاوية ابن أبي سفيان. مغيرة رضي الله عنه wrote to معاوية ابن أبي سفيان أن رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم كان يقول في دبر كل صلاة إذا سلم. That the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم used to say after every salah, دبر, after every salah, when he is to do salam, meaning after he will say assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah, assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah, he will say la ilaha illallah wahdahu la sharika lahu, lahul mulk wa lahul hamdu wa huwa ala kulli shay'in qadir, allahumma la mani'a lima a'tayta wa la mu'tiya lima mana'at wa la yanfa'u dhal jadd minka al jadd. Subhanallah. There is no God but Allah alone, no partners with Him. For Him is the kingdom, for Him is praise, and He upon everything is all powerful. O Allah, لا مانع لما أعطيت, nobody can stop what you give. If you were to give anything, nobody can stop you. ولا معطي لما منعت, and whatever you don't want to give, nobody can make you give. If you stop something from someone, nobody can make them give. So ultimately, giving Not giving is in your control. Is it? Whatever will be given to me today, ultimately is from you. Whatever will not be given to me today, ultimately is from you. Such faith. Only Allah can fulfill my needs. وَلَا يَنْفَعُ ذَا الْجَدِّ مِنْكَ الْجَدِّ. And no person of rich can help from you in any way. Meaning, you are the richest of all rich. The way you can benefit me, no other person in the world can benefit me. You know, today we look at certain rich people. We look at the car, we look at the, you know, their jobs, etc., the way they are. And we say, wow, we need to keep connection with this guy. Some guy to hang around with. And the pockets are quite full. Whatever he can give you, Allah can give you millions of times better than that. Keep connected with Allah. Allah is the one who has given him. Can Allah not give you? Keep connected with Allah. Keep.
وقال شعبان منصور قال سمعت المسيب.
سبحان الله. So these are some very, very small deeds which we can do, yet so much great reward. I have seen it in other nationalities, other countries, where you must have seen it as well. After Salah, they all sit and read, you know, Ayatul Kursi, they read Surah Fatiha, they read, you go to Turkey after Salah, the whole masjid, everybody reading. Nobody will get up until the Imam doesn't get up. Everybody sitting there, reading, you know, the zikr, tasbih, tahmeed, qul huwallahu ahad, all the different surah, ayatul kursi, fatiha, then they all get up after the imam. You go to Malaysia, all these places. I went to Malaysia 2 years ago. After salah, nobody gets up. We were traveling, so I wanted to get up, but I was feeling out of place. I was thinking, if I get up, I'll be the only one in the masjid getting up. Everybody else is sitting there. And they all sit there. They all wait for the imam to finish. Once the imam gets up, then they all get up after him. Out of respect. We get in the hadith of Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam that the sahaba never used to get up until the Prophet of Allah got up first. Nowadays, before the imam gets up, the masjid is already empty. He said, Imam, you stay there. We've got more important things to do. We don't have time to wait around with you, behind you here. Allah give us the ability. So let us value these moments after Salah. Let us read, make this part of our reading, and then see how Allah bless us in this world. And more than anything, Allah bless us in the Akhirah. The life of this world is very, very short. If you know, people who are given things, their life goes as well. And those who are not given anything, their life also passes by. But the real blessing is the blessing of the Akhirah. The real blessing is the blessing which Allah will give there. So Allah give us in this world as well, bless us in this world, but much more Allah give us there. Today, unfortunately, our mindset is different. Allah, give me everything in this world. No, Allah, much more I need it there. Because there I will be there forever and ever. Allah, give me much more there. Allah, shower me in this world as much as you can, or as much as, you know, I need, whatever you think, you know. But in the Akhirah, I need more. Allah, give all of us the ability, inshallah. Subhanallah, bihamdihi, subhanakallahumma wa bihamdika, ashhadu an la ilaha illa anta. Any questions?